it's very unscientific to measure the time that you want to give for that item to get properly cooked in terms of number of whistles. Hello friends. For success in life, we need to have a high curiosity quotient. I am Prakash Shesh, and in this series of in and out of the box videos, we are going to seek answers which you should have done long ago. In order to understand this, we must go to our 6th or 7th class physics in order to understand how does a pressure cooker work? Why does it cook faster than a normal mode of cooking? You remember Denis Papin, the British physicist, invented the pressure cooker. And the main reason why a pressure cooker cooks faster is because it does not allow the steam to escape, as a result of which the pressure inside the cooker increases. And it is a known fact that when a liquid is subjected to increased pressure, its boiling point also increases. So while water boils at 100 degrees Celsius when it is open to the atmosphere, the water inside the pressure cooker boils at around 130 degrees Celsius. That means its boiling point goes up because of the increased pressure. And because food is being cooked now at 130 degrees Celsius, it gets cooked faster. So this is the principle on which a pressure cooker works. Now, if you try to measure the amount of cooking that is taking place inside the pressure cooker by the number of whistles, now all of us know that there is a whistle which comes along with every pressure cooker, and it is mainly a safety device. It allows the steam inside to escape so that the pressure cooker should not explode. But should we use the number of whistles, which is commonly used by most Indian housewives, even in recipes, it is said that keep it for 3 whistles. According to me, it's very unscientific to measure the time that you want to give for that item to get properly cooked in terms of number of whistles. Because what happens? When a whistle sounds, the inside steam escapes out, and therefore the steam at a high pressure, or rather at a high boiling point, which is available inside the pressure cooker to cook it faster, reduces in volume. We don't want to do that. Similarly, that escaped steam actually increases the temperature of your kitchen, because now superheated steam is, therefore you will see most Indian kitchens, they are quite sultry because a lot of steam has escaped, and the heat is probably making the cooking person, that means the housewife, perspire more. So therefore, the best way or the correct way of using a pressure cooker would be that when the whistle starts hissing, it is not actually letting out steam, it starts hissing. That means you know that if you keep the gas on now, it will start giving out whistles. At that stage, you should reduce the gas input to the pressure cooker, so that you are reducing the heat input to the pressure cooker, and as a result, the hissing never gets converted into escaping of steam, because escaping of steam is inefficient for the transfer of heat inside the cooker as well as the atmosphere or the environment outside in the kitchen. So therefore, next time you find out how many minutes you should keep it, so that a particular, suppose you require 3 minutes to cook chole bature and you require 10 minutes to cook mutton, then as soon as the hissing starts, reduce the gas flow. That means reduce the heat flow to the pressure cooker and let no whistles come out, and just keep it for 10 minutes or 3 minutes without any whistling, and you will find that the item gets cooked as well as it was when you were allowing it to give out whistles, because whistles means waste of energy.
For more such interesting facts from Prakash Shesh, please like this video and subscribe to our channel.